Hey, what's up? Well, it only took 2.5 weeks, but I finally got my Hatchet gear, which is one of these new twisted shirts. And it is tight as a motherfucker. It's got like that material that just does not move, stretch, or give at all. So, fat kids out there, you may want to get the 5X because the 2 and 3X are really nothing like the size they claim to be. But anyway, today is day one for me rebooting the whole raw vegan thing. And as I said before, I said that I was gonna do raw vegan with the exception of yogurt so that I could take those nasty ass supplements, but I don't think I'm gonna continue on the supplements because I've kind of slacked off of taking them for the past week and I feel fine without them. So I think the only supplement I'm gonna continue with is the cream jar of the Tribulus and Chrysin. That shit's real expensive. It's $40 for a 4-ounce jar, but I think it works. It gives me more energy, and that's the only thing I'm gonna do. And I don't have to swallow that because it's a topical cream. You just rub it into your skin, and that's all I'm gonna use. So the rest of it, fuck it. I mean, I might continue with like the flaxseed oil and the milk thistle because those are really thin liquids and they're not too terrible. But other than that, I'm just not going to bother with the pills, which means I won't have to do the yogurt, which means I can go raw vegan, which is, you know, nothing but raw, uncooked fruit, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. And that's it. And today's day one, and I'm going to stick with it this time because, I mean, I know I've fucked up so much in the past. I know I've fucked up. But, you know, there comes a time when you just got to get your shit together once and for all. And honestly, you know, more than anything I want out of life, you know, hatred propels me more than, you know, my own motivations for, you know, wanting to be a photographer and filmmaker. More than making movies, more than, you know, traveling the world, more than, you know, getting a little bit of respect out of people. Mostly, I'm gonna do it just to fucking prove that I am somebody and that I can do what I put my mind to and that nothing will get in my way of what I want. And which brings me to a lot of other stuff that I want to get to here. Both Big Irish and Panic. Saw both your videos today, and both of them have a lot that I want to respond to here. And first of all, to Big Irish, you still have never made a video explaining your views and beliefs on karma, because as we've had this discussion before when it comes to trolls and, you know, the three little assholes here that are always starting shit with me and other juggalos, you've always, you know, said that they're already getting, you know, their bad karma. They're already getting what they deserve because their lives are shit. But I don't think that someone having a life of shit to where all they can do is hate on others and throw that shit out to other people, I don't think that that's enough of a payback. I mean, maybe I'm just like really vengeful or something, but I really think that people who are just genuinely nasty assholes who have nothing to give except to throw out hatred, nastiness, and degrade and put down everybody else, I think people like that really deserve more of an ass fucking from karma than to just have such a shitty life to where that's all they can do is throw that shit back out, you know, to make themselves feel better. I really think people like that deserve a little more misery. And I know you've said before that they are getting what they deserve because they don't have the capacity within themselves to feel love and compassion and everything else, but still, I don't think it's enough. So I'm still waiting for you to make a video on your views on karma and, you know, how you believe that works and stuff, because honestly, I don't believe it even exists, because the absolute most terrible people in the world, you know, get away with it. There's terrible things that happen every day the world round, you know. Animals are tortured and killed and tested on and abused in horrible ways. You know, children are tortured and raped and abused in horrible ways, and these people get away with it. You know, justice never fucking gets served, so I don't really believe in karma, so I'm still waiting to hear your thoughts on all that, so yeah. And then there's Panic's video up on Carnival Spirits, and I'm so glad you posted this because I haven't heard that song before. I know it's weird and everything. As much as I love Twisted, you know, they're my favorite group in the whole world, but maybe I'm just like too ADD or something, just too off in my own little world to where I haven't, you know, sought out absolutely everything that they've ever put out, every song that they've ever been on someone else's album or mixtape or whatnot. I haven't really, you know, taken the time to dig up absolutely everything that they've ever touched. So yeah, I haven't heard this song, but when I listened to it, yeah, it really struck me as deeply as it does for you, like when you're going through some of the lyrics there. And you know, I've said this before, you know, I've gone through my whole life. You know, I never really had any guidance growing up. I was basically left to my own devices. I mean, I grew up with, you know, a mom that just yelled and screamed and rant and raved and threw things, and, you know, that doesn't fucking teach a kid anything. I never had guidance. I never had, you know, that love and everything. And, you know, that's something I've always thought, you know, in the back of my mind about, you know, Twisted and ICP and, you know, everyone else that I look up to now, is that, you know, they must have had, you know, awesome, awesome, loving parents, because you don't get to be a success in your 20s, especially early 20s. You don't get, you know, to be somebody at, you know, 20, 22 or whatever years old by, you know, having parents that don't care about you or tell you that you're stupid and worthless and you're not gonna amount to shit. You only get there by, you know, just having an awesome, supportive, loving family environment and good friends and everything else. And like when you get to the lyrics about, you know, not wasting time, you know, like I said, I wasn't raised at all. I was left to my own devices. It was basically like, you know, fuck you, you don't matter. And that's the way I grew up. So I didn't have anyone telling me that I needed to do this and this and this and this in order to get somewhere as an adult. And yeah, so yeah, a lot of time has been wasted, and I know I'm playing catch up. I know I got so much to make up for. I've got to lose all this weight to get anywhere, because as long as you're big, people think you're fucking stupid and worthless and can't do anything. People just don't seem to realize that. You know, like I was going off on this but on Twitter, people just don't realize that, you know, your weight or your body size or shape has nothing to do with what's in here, or, you know, what's in here even. It has nothing to do with your heart, your mind, your intelligence level, your talents, your capabilities. And it really sucks that we live in a world like that, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do sometimes. And yeah, but Yeah, I know. Like I said in the beginning of the video, I'm more driven by hate. I'm more driven to lose weight, to beat someone's ass just to say, you know what, fuck you, than I am for my own, you know, personal reasons and personal gain and betterment and all that. But yeah, as I was saying, you know, growing up the way I did, not having that love and support, not having that guidance, not having someone telling me, you know, this is what you, you know, need to do to, you know, move on and move up in life. I basically just lived my later teen years, you know, doing, you know, whatever the fuck I want. I was homeless and on the streets and I was free for once. And then I came back here and I got my first college degree, you know, thinking that's what, you know, I needed to do to get somewhere. And then I learned, you know, over the next several years the hard way that, you know, nobody hires fat people. So that's why I am where I am. And now I'm working on my second degree, which, by the way, I've got a 4.0. So, again, fuck the bitches. But, yeah, the thing is that, you know, all my life, you know, counting, you know, teen years and beyond, I've just, you know, not listened to anybody. And it's probably because I didn't have that love and support and that guidance growing up. You know, I didn't have adults in my life, in my early, you know, life that, you know, had it together and, you know, taught me how to have it together. So I guess maybe I just learned to not listen to anybody, and that's the way I've always been. I don't listen to anybody. I do exactly what the fuck I want, when the fuck I want, and fuck everybody else. But when it comes to Twisted, that's the only people I listen to. Everyone else, it's like, I don't care, I'm not listening, fuck you. But when Twisted speaks, it's like, yes, sir. You know, I'm fucking listening. But, yeah, that's really motivational, and I'm glad you post that, put me up on that. Definitely gonna have to get that downloaded, and yes, they are very motivational in so much of their stuff. I'm not even just talking that song or just Abominations. You know, so much of their music is uplifting and motivational to me, you know. But I'm about to wrap this up, and I just want to say, you know, there's two different philosophies out there. There's everyone else's philosophy, and then there's mine. Everyone else's philosophy is don't feed the trolls, don't give them any attention, they'll go away. Well, guess what? They don't go away. You know, I was told that when I was a little kid in elementary school. Everyone told me if I just ignored the bullies, they'd go away. It doesn't, because if you ignore them, they try even harder. They attack even harder. They escalate everything in order to break you down. And the reason I keep addressing them and come back is the same reason why they keep coming back at me and anyone else that they go after, is because they think that they're eventually going to break me. They think they're eventually going to get me to close down my account and everything else. They think that they can stop me from doing what I want to do. And I just come back again and again and again just to piss them off. I'm doing the same thing that they're doing. That's my philosophy, is to not give in. My philosophy is to get in their face and show them that they're not making me go anywhere, that I'm always going to be here. You know, 10 years down the road, if YouTube still exists, I'm still going to put up videos. They're not getting rid of me. They will never get rid of me. They will never make me stop. They will never make me quit. They will never change who I am. They will never get me to be feminine. They will never get me to be what they want me to be. They will never get me to close my account. They will never get me to kill myself. They will never get me to do anything but what I want to do. Just like I said, that's who I am. I do what I want when the fuck I want, and fuck everybody and everything else. It's about me. Yeah, it really is. So I come back just to piss them off, just to burn their ass, because they have got to be sitting there like, ah, Twisted Ash made another video. Ah, I can't get rid of him. Ah. And it's like, sorry, you're not gonna get rid of me. So I do it to just be in their face as much as they think that they're getting in my face. The only difference is, yeah, we don't see their faces, so they're not really in my face, so to speak, but I'm in their face. I'm in their face saying, yeah, you can't get rid of me. But yeah, that's why I do it. That's why I, you know, retaliate. It's simply just to show them that they're not going to get anywhere, ever, when it comes to trying to get rid of me or get me down or anything else. It's not going to happen. Never. Always fucking bounce back. But, that's all I got for now. I gotta go, gotta edit this video together, because my train of thought is just totally derailed today. I don't know what it is, but yeah, whoop whoop fam, deuces. I don't know, still haven't come up with another ending, but yeah, I'm out.